Okay, let's talk about bullet drop compensators. Some people say they don't work. I say they do, if you use them correctly. Now, some people claim that a bullet drop compensator only works for one round under one set of conditions. That's just not true. As we have demonstrated, the trajectory is determined by the ballistic coefficiency and the velocity. As long as you have similar properties in your ammunition, you will have similar values, and the ballistic drop compensator will work for various loads. Now, this one here is set up for my hunting load, and as you see, I'm just dialing the range with my training load. So I have at least three cartridges that I use with this turret, and I just dial to range, and it works very well inside these ranges. And so, just to illustrate how similar they are, we're going to just use the BDC, no ballistic calculators, and just dial to range at the 5A2 target. So we have the ballistic bar as a reference. And another thing you should keep track of is your calibration. I usually just put it right on the turret here. And for my turret, I always calibrate it for 970 hectopascal and 10 or 12, as in this case, degrees. And today we saw in the forecast that we have supposed to have, I haven't checked, we're supposed to have significantly higher pressure compared to my calibration, 970 versus 1000. So I should dial as close to 592 as I can, and it should be pretty perfect. Just underneath, pretty perfect for wind. So that was just dialed to range with a different type of ammunition, and because the ballistic coefficiency and the velocity is quite similar, it's more or less spot on. The shooting wasn't top now. Okay, and another thing you need to understand is that a BDC does not change the mechanics of the scope. It's just putting a representative value, yards or meters, for a number of clicks. And